It brought us the Roaring Twenties, the Space Age and the Information Age, the 50s and the 60s. Radio, television, satellites and cell phones all caught up in a swirling sea of change. And it introduced a new voice in music, our voice. From the ground to the air to the sky to the concert hall, this has been the American Century. Welcome to the American Century, an exploration of America's modern musical legacy, hosted by David Dubal. The American Century is sponsored on 96.3 FM WQXR by American Century Investments, with over 40 years mutual fund management experience.
Welcome to the American Century. I am David Dubal. In this program, we present five works: music by James P. Johnson, Charles Tomlinson Griffiths, Howard Hanson, Lucas Foss, and Mr. George Gershwin. James P. Johnson is best known as the father of stride piano, a style of playing that developed from ragtime and produced an extraordinary group of pianists. He wrote a great deal of music. All of it has flavor and flair. On this program, we hear Victory Stride, one of his best-known scores. You will hear members of the Concordia Orchestra in this performance. The music by James P. Johnson, Victory Stride, and the performance by members of the Concordia Orchestra. This is the American Century, heard each Sunday at 12:05 on 96.3 FM WQXR. Our next composer is Charles Tomlinson Griffiths, a composer I adore. Born in 1884, he lived only until 1920. He wrote music that was influenced by Debussy, Ravel, and Scriabin, but in everything he touched, this American Impressionist was a master, each piece crafted like fine jewelry. The poem for flute and orchestra is a 1918 creation. The textures shimmer, the flute writing glistens. In all, there is magic in every measure. In this performance, Joseph Mariano is the soloist, with Howard Hanson conducting the Eastman Rochester Orchestra. Griffiths, Poem for Flute and Orchestra.
Thank you.
The soloist Joseph Mariano, Howard Hanson conducting the Eastman Rochester Orchestra in Charles Griffith's Poem for Flute and Orchestra, a 1918 work. This is David Dubal, your host for The American Century, WQXR's weekly tribute to American composition of the 20th century. We just heard Howard Hanson conducting Griffiths, and now we sample Hanson's own music, the finale of his Second Symphony. Howard Hanson was born in 1896 in Wahoo, Nebraska, but his name is forever linked with the Eastman School of Music and the Eastman Rochester Symphony. He died in 1981 after a richly productive life. His music is part of the great Romantic period, and he has been compared to Sibelius. But Hanson was his own man. As a conductor, he championed every variety of 20th century music, but his own music is primarily warm and filled with a large spirit. His Symphony No. 2, subtitled The Romantic, was premiered in 1930 by Serge Koussevitzky in Boston. Hanson wrote, "My aim in this symphony has been to create a work young in spirit, romantic in temperament, and simple and direct in expression." On today's edition of The American Century, we hear the finale marked Allegro con brio. Leonard Slatkin is heard conducting the St. Louis Symphony.
Thank you.
The music was Howard Hanson's finale, the third movement Allegro con brio of his Romantic Symphony, Opus 30. The St. Louis Symphony was conducted by Leonard Slatkin. This is David Dubal, your host for the American Century. We'll return in a moment with music by Lucas Foss. One of the most famous American composers is Lucas Foss, born in 1922, a dynamo who plays piano, conducts with passion, and writes marvelous music, which always has the Fossian imprint. His three American pieces are delightful, composed in 1944. They have been frequently performed for violin and piano under the heading Three Early Pieces. After Itzhak Perlman asked Foss to recast them for orchestra, he changed the title into Three American Pieces. Foss has said, "All three pieces are melodious and virtuosic. I wish I could write music that simple and straightforward American music now." In these three American pieces, Itzhak Perlman is the soloist, Seiji Ozawa conducting the Boston Symphony Orchestra.
Thank you.
Three American Pieces by Lucas Foss, born 1922. It was Itzhak Perlman, the violinist, and Seiji Ozawa conducted the Boston Symphony Orchestra. To conclude music on the American century, we are treated to George Gershwin's wonderful Cuban Overture. Gershwin was born in New York in 1898, and he died in 1937. What a tragedy for American music. And for the world, for that matter. Gershwin is certainly the best loved of any American composer. This is the 100th anniversary of his birth, and Gershwin works are appearing worldwide to celebrate his birthday. This Cuban overture is filled with color and Latin flavor. The 1930s found an explosion of Latin dances in the United States, and Gershwin, like Aaron Copland, wrote delicious orchestral works that exploit the Latin beat and atmosphere. In this performance, Zubin Mehta conducts the New York Philharmonic in George Gershwin's Cuban Overture.
Thank you.
York Philharmonic was conducted by Zubin Mehta, the music George Gershwin's Cuban Overture. And that is the final offering on today's edition of The American Century. We'll return to take a look at next week's program right after this message from American Century Investments. American Century, with over 40 years mutual fund management experience. Next week on The American Century, we hear music of Giancarlo Menotti, Morton Gould, Leo Sowerby, George Chadwick, and Charles Ives. This is David Dubal. Thank you for listening.
Thank you.